Hey guys, welcome back to Unity Gurus. In this video, you will learn how you can use displacement in Unity's high definition render pipeline and standard render pipeline. So let's get started. PUBG? नहीं यार, मैं काम कर रहा हूँ अभी यार, मैं बाद में खेलेंगे.
शुरू किया है.
एक बंदा आया. हाँ.
टडा, वेलकम टू क्विक्सेल मिक्सर बीज 2019.2.1 बेटा. आई नो दिस इज़ नॉट ए क्विक्सेल ट्यूटोरियल, बट द रीज़न बिहाइंड शोइंग यू दिस सीन इज़ दैट वी गोइंग टू यूज़ दिस डिस्प्लेसमेंट मैप इनसाइड यूनिटी एंड वी विल ट्राई टू अचीव द सेम क्वालिटी इन यूनिटी. द सेकेंड मेन रीजन फॉर यूजिंग दिस क्विक्सेल मिक्सर इज़ दैट यू कैन ईजिली जनरेट 4K हाई रेजोल्यूशन टेक्चर मैप्स फ्रॉम दिस सॉफ्टवेयर. सो आई हैव ओपन अप ए डेमो सीन विच ऑलरेडी कम्स विद दिस क्विक्सेल मिक्सर. हियर व्हाट यू नीड टू डू, just go to export and in the surface name type the name of your texture and assign the path, and in this export format choose the format you want. PNG or TIFF would be fine. Here you can set your resolution. You can export this texture up to 8K resolution. By default it is set to PNG 8-bit. You don't need to change anything. And the displacement setting, make sure it is set to EXR 32-bit image. Basically this will provide you much more detail in your displacement map than other 8-bit images. Then just click on this export button and it will export all the texture in this folder. Here you can see I have exported all the textures. Let's copy these textures in Unity and start from there. Alright, so now we are inside Unity and I have already set up the HD render pipeline, which I have already explained a lot of time in my previous video. So if you are new, you can watch my previous video to set up this pipeline. Basically, this is a direction light and I'm using a HDRI sky, and I'm using this HDRI sky in the scene environment, and it is also imported as a cube map. And here are the texture which I exported from Quixel Mixer. One thing I have done here, I have already made this mask map. If you don't know about this mask map, please watch my video about Materialize, where I have explained how you can make this mask map inside Photoshop. Basically, in the red channel, I have pasted the metallic. In the green, ambient occlusion. Blue is black and alpha is smoothness. However, this will be not so useful because we are mainly going to focus on displacement. I have imported this texture on 4K resolution. And for this displacement map, I'm using 4K size and I'm not using any kind of compression so that we can get maximum details from this displacement map. I have also made this standard lit material. Let's reset this one. And I have applied to this plane. You can see this is a default Unity plane. Let's quickly assign this texture in proper slot. So diffuse in the base map, in the mask map, in the normal map. And by the way, for the normal map, you should import them as a normal map. And you see that there is no option to put our displacement map because by default the displacement mode is set to none. So if you click on this button, there are basically two types of displacement map. Let's first talk about this pixel displacement. So once you select that, so now we have one more option, which is height map. So basically this is the slot in which we are gonna use our displacement map. So I assign this displacement map in the height map slot and you immediately see some changes in this texture. So if I set the amplitude to 0, you can see it's now back to normal. Let's have a closer look, and if I increase this displacement, now you can see bumps in this texture. And for this weird problem, you just increase this fading bitmap level. So you see now we are definitely seeing some displacement in our texture, but you see when I change my camera angle, it's just a flat plane. Because this pixel displacement is kind of fake displacement. Even though it looks very real, but it's totally fake. It is very useful when you want to get details and you also want to optimize your game. But to get the real quality, you need to use vertex displacement. So let's change this displacement mode to vertex displacement. And you see now it's back to flat because the height is set to maximum 1. So let's change this to amplitude. And now if I increase the amplitude, you can see some real displacement in our texture. But you see that the details are not looking real. So if I switch to wireframe mode, you can see even though this plane is deformed, but it's very low polygon. That's why we are not getting proper details. So how do we achieve better details on this plane? Well, to show that, I have imported a test object. So let me quickly import that one. To explain that, I have imported two identical planes. So let's assign material to these planes. Now you see that this plane is looking much better than this one. And these two planes are looking identical. So what's so special about this plane? Why this is looking better than these two planes? To see that, let's again switch to wireframe mode. If I select all of them, now you can clearly see that this plane has a lot of geometry. where these two planes have low polygons. So basically what I did that I divided this mesh multiple times in the 3D software, and that's why we are getting better details on this plane, because by default the Unity plane is also very low polygon, so that's why we cannot see better details in it. So the conclusion is, to get the proper detail you also need to have a high polygon object. So now the question is, should we use high polygon object in our games? Then what about the performance? How can we maintain the detail and the performance at the same time? Well, the answer is no. You don't need to use high poly object in your games or in your demos. There is already a solution for that. That is called real-time tessellation. Let me show you how you can get the same details on this low polygon object without even subdividing it. So if you go to this shader option, go to HDRP, and you see that there is another option called lit tessellation. So let's switch to this one. You see everything's back to normal. Our displacement is gone. What this shader does is that it real-time tessellate your object according to your displacement map. So basically what it does, it automatically subdivide your mesh according to the camera distance and the detail of your object. So to explain that, go into displacement mode and choose tessellation displacement. And now you see, we have the same level of detail on this low polygon object as well. And if I now switch to wireframe mode, even so the polygon count is not so dense, but it is definitely more than normal. And we are definitely seeing some details on this object, which is pretty good. So the first option is the Phong, which is basically the algorithm which is used to tessellate the object. I don't have any idea of how this works, so let's keep it to Phong. The next option is tessellation factor. The tessellation factor is used to control the amount of tessellation for your object. If you hover over this option, it will tell you that for the Xbox and PS4, the maximum tessellation factor is 15. So if you are building game for Xbox or PS4, keep it to 15. It will give you all the details and also control your performance. Okay, so for now, just keep it to maximum. This start and end phase distance is used to control the tessellation for this object. For example, if I set this end phase distance to 10, this means after 10 meters, there will be no tessellation. And this start phase distance is used to smooth out this tessellation effect. For example, if I set this to 5, this means after 5 meters, it will gradually fade out the tessellation effect until 10 meters. The triangle size is the size of each triangle in pixel units, which basically means if you use lower value, which means smaller triangles and more polygon count, and if you increase this value, which means bigger triangles and low polygon count. I don't know what this shape factor does. I think it's related to this Phong mode. This culling option is to enable backface culling in your object. Watch in this material preview window. If I decrease this value to -1, which means no polygon culling, and if I increase, which means complete polygon culling. If we increase or decrease this culling option, the back faces are automatically hidden, which means like the polygons which are not currently visible on from the camera will be hidden. Next, in this height map option, you can choose the minimum and maximum value like this. Offset is used to like completely move all the values, or you can choose this amplitude, which basically define the height of this displacement map. From this base value, you can basically increase and decrease the height of the point from where this displacement map is calculated. Lastly, I want to show you what this tessellation actually does. So like if I zoom out my camera, you can see now all the tessellation is gone. And when I zoom into this object, you can see now all the tessellation is come back. So that's why it's called real-time tessellation. So that's why this real-time tessellation option is used in most of the games, instead of subdividing your mesh in your 3D software. I also want to tell you a few things you need to keep in mind when working with displacement maps. Here is one more copy of this displacement map, but this time I choose 8-bit in export option. Let's apply this material to the object and see what's the difference between 32-bit and 8-bit displacement map. And in the 8-bit, I change the displacement map to 8-bit. Here you can see all the parameters of both materials are same, but you can see the result is totally different. With 8-bit texture, you don't see the minor details in your texture. You can see the tessellation is working fine on both objects, but the minor details are not visible in 8-bit texture. And that's the main reason why you choose 32-bit images for displacement maps. You can also use 16-bit images. They also work fine for displacement map. Let me show you an example of 16-bit displacement map. So let's duplicate this one. I have also made a rock material with 16-bit displacement image. This height map is a 16-bit texture map, which I downloaded from freepbr.com. I will also give a link in the description for that. And it's also looking very nice. we are getting minor detail on this texture. One more thing I want to tell about using displacement map. You can see right now I have set the compression to none. If I set the compression to a normal quality, you will see what happens in the details. You can see that now all the details are gone and it's looking like this 8-bit image. So make sure not to use any kind of compression on your displacement map. So that's how we can use displacement in high definition render pipeline. Let's quickly have a look how we can use this displacement map in Unity's standard render pipeline. In the lightweight render pipeline, I think the displacement is not supported unless you make a custom shader using shader graph. So let me quickly change the scene to standard pipeline and see how we can use displacement in that pipeline as well. Alright, now I'm back to standard pipeline and this is a standard material. Let's quickly apply this texture into this slot. And you can see that this displacement is same like a pixel displacement in HDRP material, which is kind of fake material. And if you look closely, you can control this distance. You can see there is no displacement in the object, which is, by the way, still very nice. Okay, how do we use actual displacement in standard pipeline? Well, by default, there is no shader which you can use in standard pipeline. You need to use custom or third-party shader to get the displacement in standard pipeline. And luckily, there is a one shader which is available for free on Asset Store. So let's import that one. Go to Asset Store and type displacement here. And this is the displacement and click on this first DirectX DX11 tessellation displacement. This is available for free and click import. By the way, to use this displacement in standard pipeline, you need to have a graphics card which support DirectX 11. How do you find whether your graphic card support DirectX 11 or not? Just go to the website and check the details of your graphic card whether it support DirectX 11 or not. Now the package is imported and this comes with a couple of shaders. This also have a demo scene where you can see the displacement effect. So now if you go to your shader and you will find a tessellation shader, and in this one you will find three options: pimped distance, test standard and specular. So I'm going to use this test standard. And now you can see that immediately you can see some displacement in your object. If I switch to wireframe mode, you can definitely, it's definitely tessellating our object in real time. And if I zoom out, you can see that now our object has changed to a low polygon version. And if I zoom in back, it's definitely working. So let's have a look at the parameters. Ek minute ruk ja. So basically this is same like standard shader, but it has additional option for tessellation. Let's switch back to wireframe mode. So it has two tessellation mode: edge length and distance bit. This edge length is basically length in pixels. It's same like triangle size in HDRP. The higher the length, the bigger the triangles. Pretty simple. This is the tessellation factor, same like HDRP tessellation material. This phone smoothing, I don't know what it does. This displacement scale is basically to scale the displacement level. And this is the offset, same like HDRPs. I think this one is more optimized than HDRPs because you see that the polygon count is not so dense, but yet we are getting all the details in our mesh, which is very cool. And even from a distance, it's automatically decreasing the tessellation level, changing the tessellation in real time, which is very useful for games and optimization. So that's a quick overview of how we can use displacement in Unity's standard and HDRP render pipeline. So now my job is done. Now it's your time. Please subscribe, watch and blah blah blah. I also want to thank you Spark, Hannah Sinkonen, I don't know if I'm pronouncing right, and Peter Listek for their great Patreon support. I'm really very happy to know that people appreciate my work and they are supporting me as well. See you in the next video. Bye bye. Aja aja. Bullu, aja. PUBG khelte hain. तू लैपटॉप चालू कर, मार रहा हूँ।